I think everyone's scared of not fitting in. I was. I still am. And I think because of this, there's been a lot of different versions of myself to get to the person that I am today. And I think the one thing that's influenced change in me more than anything else is music. I remember the first album I owned. It was Pink's Misunderstood, and I stand by that album to this day. I was 7, my mom asked me what I wanted for my birthday, and that was it. Pink was really popular in 2002. This wasn't just the first album I ever owned, but this was also the first time I'd really felt an emotional response to music. On songs like Family Portrait, here she was writing from the perspective of a child going through exactly what I was going through. Divorce. Songs like this spoke to what I was feeling at the time. Feelings of confusion, of guilt and helplessness. I was into some random music after Pink, some examples being the Backstreet Boys, the Black Eyed Peas, and I guess later on, Blink-182. But it wasn't until 2005 that I really experienced a musical obsession. My grandmother bought me Green Day's American Idiot, and everything changed. Then my neighbor stole it. So I bought it again. I remember I could identify every song off of every single one of their live albums before the music even started, just by the sound of the audience. I was that obsessed. Nothing particularly profound came out of my Green Day obsession, I just really, really liked them. There was something about their pop-punk sound with their cheesy political overtones that really spoke to a young, angsty me. And they stayed my favorite band until quite late until high school. Green Day heavily influenced me when I was younger. I dressed like them, I spoke like them, and I started a band like them. But my musical style was never very influenced by Green Day. I started playing the guitar partly because I was a 13-year-old boy and that's what 13-year-old boys do, but largely because my dad played the guitar. Not living with my dad meant that I barely saw him, making it really difficult to create that father-son emotional bond. So I thought that playing the guitar would be something that we could have in common. And while we started speaking more about guitar, our relationship never really got any deeper than that. In high school, a friend of mine lent me 2 albums that shook me in a way I didn't think music could. Stone Sour's Come Whatever May, and Slipknot's Volume 3, The Subliminal Verses. This was my first experience with metal, and it really genuinely scared me. A part of me was fascinated with the gory imagery and the bad press that bands like Slipknot would get. And on the other side of the coin, the music was really what I needed at the time. It was fast-paced and angry, but the thing that really, really drew me to metal was the themes of feeling alone and feeling like no one got you and feeling like an outsider. That was something that really spoke to me at the time. This music, while really angry, helped me out of some dark places in my life. And it helped me make friends. If it wasn't for metal, I probably wouldn't have had the high school experience that I did. Rap. Now, until now, my dad had always told me that rap sucked, and I had no reason not to believe him. I mean, my dad knew everything about music. But the first time that I heard Life by Sage Francis, it blew my mind. The lyrics were insightful, personal, and deeply powerful, and the instrumentals, despite not being made by a real band with real instruments, was amazing. Best of times, the end of times. I was always on deck, I was next in line. An only child with a pen and pad, writing a list of things I could never have. Now Sage is not my favorite rapper, but he'll always hold a special place in my heart as the person that introduced me to the genre of music that probably changed me the most, and probably changed me for the best. Rap and hip-hop to me is about celebrating life despite its hardships. It's about looking out for yourself, your family, and others when you have the means to do so. It's about celebrating what you have and what you've achieved while remembering the struggle that brought you to where you are. Hip-hop has done so much for me, from opening my eyes to social issues like racial inequality, sexism, and the harm that the meat industry does. Artists like Sid the Kid, Kevin Abstract, Frank Ocean, and even Tyler the Creator helped me understand my sexuality in a way that I never would have been able to unless their music was there to help normalize something that made me feel so abnormal. For the first time in my life, I really feel like I'm the person that I'm supposed to be. And I think I have music to thank for that.